Hello students, how are you? I hope you all are fit and fine. So dear students, as you know that now we are going to revise the syllabus of next revision test paper 6th, paper 7. Okay, we are going to revise. Already we have discussed chapters from your textbook Flamingo and supplementary reader. Now we are going to discuss the writing part of your next revision test, which will be there in your next revision test, that is informal invitation. So as in this revision test third, I have separated the syllabus. I have separated formal and informal invitation. So you can understand it very well. Okay, so as we know that in informal invitation we follow the format of personal letter. Personal letter format is followed. The format of personal letter is followed. Okay, in order to write an informal invitation, we follow the format of a personal letter. Okay, so let me just write down a question which has been asked in CBSE examination 2011, and then through answer we will try to understand it in a better way. Okay, Nikhil has come out successful. Nikhil has question. Nikhil has come out. Nikhil has come out success. Come out successfully in IIT. Successfully in IIT entrance examination. In IIT entrance, sorry, examination, he has decided to throw a party. He has decided to throw a party. He has decided to throw a party to his friends, write out an informal invitation. Write out an informal invitation. Write out an informal invitation giving details of venue. Giving details of venue and date, venue time and date. Okay, venue venue, time and date. So do not exceed 50 words. Okay, so Nikhil has come out successfully in IIT entrance examination. He has decided to throw a party to his friends, write out an informal invitation giving details of venue, time and date. Okay, so let me rub it and write down one answer for you, then you will be given more questions for practice. Okay. So one thing you must keep remember, informal invitations are written in the form of personal letter. Okay, so we should follow the format of personal letter while writing an invitation. Okay, so let's start writing answer. In personal letter, we first write the address. As address is not given in the question, so we can write any address. Okay, so let us write any address as given here. M3 Satyavadi Colony. M3 Satyavadi Colony. M3 Satyavadi Colony, Ashok Vihar, Phase 3. Ashok Vihar, Phase 3, Delhi. Then date, after as we follow the format of personal letter, after address you should write date, 3rd February, after leaving a blank line, 2021. As it is personal letter, informal letter, so in informal letter we write just sender's address, we need not write receiver's address here. Okay. So, dear Arun, name of the friend, dear Arun, now give the reason for what you are throwing the party. As you are aware that I have successfully, you can start this way, as you are aware that I have successfully successfully cleared, passed. Okay, you can write anything. As you are aware that I have successfully passed, or you can also write I have come out successfully in IIT entrance examination as given in the question. So we have right, same as given in the question, it would be easier for us. Okay, so as given in the question, I have come out successful. It has been written already. So as you are aware that I have come out successful, not successfully. In question also it should be successful, not successfully. Okay, so change this word. I have come out successful in which exam? In IIT entrance examination. In IIT entrance examination. In IIT entrance examination, let me show you here on the board. Okay, Dear Arun, as you are aware that I have come out successful in IIT entrance examination. Let me rub it and write down the remaining part of this answer. So I have arranged a festive party. Okay. At the first stop, so I have arranged a festive party. So I have arranged a festive party to all my friends. Festive party to all my friends at let me write down the date on which you are on 5th February. Okay, so further you can write, please inform, your group of friends, and do bring, you can write the name of any friend who can make the party charming like this, so of your friends, and do bring Anisha, do bring Anisha to make the party more charming, to make the party more charming. Okay, so this way you have invited now subscription in the same way as you write after leaving a line. Okay, yours sincerely, whatever name is given, so Nikhil. Okay, yours sincerely, Nikhil. Okay, so this way, dear students, in the format of personal letter, we write an informal invitation. So an informal invitation is written in the form of personal letter, while a formal invitation is written in the form of card, as we discussed during your RT 3.1. Okay, let me rub it and discuss some more questions. I'm going to give you some more questions which have been asked in different years in CBSE examination. So question number 2, writing for your practice. Suman Suresh has Suman or Suresh has cleared the pre-medical cleared the pre-medical or pre-medical M should be capital, P also should be capital, pre-medical or pre-dental entrance examination the family is elated at the achievement. The family is elated at the achievement and they decided to have a get together and they decided to have a get together. Draft an informal invitation get together for all friends. Okay, so draft an informal invitation to get together. Informal invitation for the get together. So you have to write, it has been asked in CBSE examination 2018. Okay. Suman Suresh has cleared the pre-medical and pre-dental entrance examination. The family is elated at the achievement and they decided to have a get together for all friends. So using same format, you will have to write down answer to this question. This invitation is an informal invitation. It will be written in the same way as we have just discussed. Okay, so let me show you some more questions on your screen with the help of a PPT. Informal invitation, points to remember. You must note down these points which are very important for you. It should be within a box. First thing, yes. Written in a letter form in informal format. Such letters are persuasive in nature. So it should be written in the format of informal letter as we have just discussed, and also an example had been shown to you. written in the first person, it should be written in the first person. No receiver's address, you need not write the address of receiver. Salutation is dear plus name. Dear Rahul, you cannot write my dear friend Rahul. Dear Rahul, dear Anish, this way. Complimentary clause, yours sincerely or yours faithfully, you can write. Date of writing the invitation is given. The writer's address appears in the usual place as we write it in informal letter. In the same way it is written here. Various tenses used to suit the tenses. Now this is the format of letter form invitation. You must note down sender's address, date, then dear name, then body of the letter in first person using I, me, my, then yours, your friend, yours sincerely, then your name. As you can see, a sample informal invitation has been shown on your screen. Aluwalia Cottage, Ganganagar. Then date, my dear Sudhir, you will be very glad to know that our Gurleen is getting married on 14th October 20 whatever it is. Our son-in-law Gurpreet is a computer engineer working for Microsoft in USA. It happened all of a sudden and we didn't have enough time to prepare. How can we ever think of celebrating such an important occasion without you? Your bhabhi, me and Gurleen are eagerly waiting forward to having you with us for the wedding. Do come with family. Yours, SS Aluwalia. Okay? So this way we should represent an informal invitation. Next example. First address, 7 Akbar Ali Avenue, Delhi. 1st December, any date, any year. My dear Rohan, you have always wanted to witness a function in your auntie's school, haven't you? Well, here is your chance. I'm organizing the annual function of my school on 28th of December, 10 a.m. Do come with mom and dad to the function. I'll place a special sofa for you and your parents right next to the chief guest. Will that please you? Your aunt Madhumita. Okay. We mostly don't write such types of invitation. It is given to the person of same rank, same status. Okay. Next, you must note down it. 114 Prem Nagar, Delhi. Then date, dear Rana Sahib, you will be pleased to know that our Mayank has turned first. It's a great occasion for a party, isn't it? So get ready for an evening full of dance, music, fun and frolic,
Of course, there will be food too. Do come with Bhabhi ji and kids. Remember, 17th May, 8 p.m. Hotel Imperial, the mall. No regrets, no excuses. See you. Yours, Trilok. Okay? Next one. Just read it out. 121 Adarsh Nagar, Faridabad. 31st July, whatever the date. Dear Nikita, finally, my dream to open an exclusive showroom of my range of designer fashion clothes in your city has come true. Well, the inauguration is on 7th August, whatever the year. Guess who will inaugurate? Aishwarya Rai, who else? You have seen her on reel now. Now see her in real. Don't miss it. We will have an exclusive photograph with her. Do come. Where? Now, don't tell me you don't know that my showroom is on the mall. Time 10 a.m. Okay? So, you know, you need not write in such a flowery language, but it is informal. If you are using such flowery language, then it's okay. But while writing a formal invitation, you cannot use such flowery language. Okay, so now replies. Accepting or decline. Like an ordinary letter, as we have just discussed, same format as of informal invitation. Do not use any formal expressions, but use informal words and expressions. Use the first person, I, we, to refer to themselves. Okay, accepting the invitation. 19th Professor's Colony, Coimbatore. Date, dear Surinder and Bhabiji, whatever the salutation according to the question. I am presently surprised to receive your invitation to Gurleen's wedding. My God, has she grown so big? I still remember her as a tiny doll in a pink frock. How time flies. Well, it really is a big occasion. I will definitely join you to make arrangements and bless her. Yes, I'm coming with the whole family. Yours, Sudhir. Now, when declining or refusing. 19 Professors Colony, Coimbatore. Date and all the things will remain the same. I am pleasantly surprised to receive your invitation to Gurleen's wedding. My God, has she grown so big? I still remember her as a tiny doll in a pink frock. I would have loved to join you on this auspicious occasion, but my father is in hospital. He had a heart attack last week and needs my constant care, but my blessings are always with Gurleen. Please accept my best wishes. I'm writing to Gudia separately. Yours, Sudhir. Okay, so this way we can decline. It's all about informal invitations, in which we have discussed questions from last year question paper. Okay, more questions you can Google, and you should practice. And also in my videos I have discussed many questions which you should practice. So orally going to make you write some more questions for practice. You must note it down. Your friend Rajat, 15 Mall Road. Your friend Rajat, 15 Mall Road, Dehradun, has invited you to attend the wedding ceremony of his sister, Preeti. Writer replied, reply not more than 50 words, accepting the invitation. You are Kareem. It has been asked in CBSE examination 2010. Okay. Once again, reading the question. Your friend Rajat, 15 Mall Road, Dehradun, has invited you to attend the wedding ceremony of his father, Preeti. Write a reply in not more than 50 words, accepting the invitation. You are Kareem. Okay. So it's all about it, dear students. In this video we have discussed the informal invitation replies. Okay, each and everything which will be there in your next revision test. So please go through and practice. Thank you for watching. See you tomorrow.